Greetings. I'm Martin Crabtree from the Mercer County Community College Library. I'd like to spend a couple moments speaking with you about Works Cited pages in MLA formatting. The Works Cited page in your paper is likely to be the first place your professor looks when they start to grade your paper. In talking with instructors over the years, many times they say they look at the list of sources first, partly to get a sense of what kinds of sources you use to get an idea of what you might be speaking about in your paper. Also to make sure that you met all the requirements of the assignment, number of sources, kinds of sources, things like that. You want to make a good first impression with your professor. So you want to have a Works Cited page that is formatted correctly. Now in an MLA formatted Works Cited page, first thing you need, the words Works Cited at the top of the page, centered. Each citation should have a hanging indentation. The entire page should be double line spaced. You also want to have all the citations in alphabetical order, and you do not want to have any hyperlinks, live links, the blue, the underline on the page, just straight text. Also, you want to use the same font size and the same font style as the rest of your paper. And you can format your Works Cited page really quite quickly. I want to show you how to do that in Microsoft Word. I have a Works Cited page that I started putting together here. I put the words Works Cited at the top of the page, and it is plural works because there's more than one item in the list. Also, these words are not bold, they're not underlined, they're just two typed words, Works Cited. Below that, I have all the citations I grabbed from our databases, and this is the kind of stuff that can happen when you grab citations from other places. The formatting will not all line up. And I just drop these in. This is what I got when I drop things in. Most of what I'm going to be doing occurs in the paragraph section of the home toolbar in Microsoft Word. First thing I'm going to do, put Works Cited in the middle of the page. I just need to have my cursor on this line, the beginning, the middle, the end, it doesn't matter, as long as it's within this line. And up here in paragraph, the second line of options, going to click on center, the lines lined up in the middle, clicking on that puts the words Works Cited in the middle of the page. And rather than doing other things to put it in the middle, like tabbing over or kind of eyeballing it, I can change the words, add words, delete words, change the size of the lettering, whatever. It will always remain right in the middle of the page is what I need. For the citations themselves, I tend to do this all in one shot. There's no need to format everyone as you drop it in. You can do it just in one shot, and I've done this for, you know, multiple pages of citations. It works quite cleanly. In the paragraph portion of the toolbar, in the lower right-hand corner is a little box with an arrow pointing down. If we hover over it, we can get what's called paragraph settings. We'll click on it, and we get these options here. Second item here, indentation. Here's where we'll set up the hanging indentation. Left and right should be set to zero. It may not be exactly as you see here, but bottom line, you need to have the number zero in both left and right. You want to go all the way out to the margins. You want a special indentation. We'll use the drop down here. Select hanging. You want a hanging indentation. And we want the half inch default. That's fine. We're not going to change that. The line spacing, the double line spacing occurs here. Before and after, again, should be set to zero. And I'll use the drop down and select double. When I'm doing this for myself, it's just real fast. Four zeros down the left-hand side, the word hanging, the word double, I'm good to go. We'll click on OK. And now things are formatted for us fairly nicely. I'm still not in alphabetical order though. And while I have everything highlighted, I'm gonna go up here to the toolbar again and the A to Z drop down, the arrow down button, the sort button, I'm gonna click on that. And this will allow me to alphabetize my list. I'm going to sort by paragraph. Word thinks of each individual citation as a paragraph, and I'm putting it in a text order, in ABC order. I could say put it in a numeric or date order, but I'm going in text order just by the letters, and it's ascending, A to Z, not in reverse order, descending Z to A. So again, paragraph, text ascending, click on OK, and it reformats and rearranges the list for me. I've run into one problem though. The very first citation starts with the letter T, and that's not where it should be in the list alphabetically. What's happened is the way a computer alphabetizes things, all punctuation comes before the letter A. And in this case, the very first character in the line is double quotes, a punctuation mark. Consequently, it comes before everything else. what I need to do is delete the double quote. I got to remember where I put it, where I deleted it, so I can put it back in a moment, and re-highlight my citations. Again, go back here to sort, paragraph, text ascending, click on OK. Now it rearranges things and puts this T down at the bottom of the list where it ought to be. I just got to remember to replace the double quotes that I removed a moment ago. I have a live link down here, the blue, the underline. I don't want to have that. And if I hover over the blue hyperlink and right click, I get a number of options right here in the middle. Remove hyperlink. I'm going to click on that. It takes it away and leaves it just as straight text, which is what we want for MLA formatting. Now I'm going to highlight everything, including Works Cited, and I want to put it all in the same font size and style. And I'm going to go down here to Times New Roman. And I'll make it 12 point, commonly used size. And now I have a Works Cited page that's properly formatted. One added comment, the second citation here, you'll notice right in the middle, a big gap. You might be concerned about that. Don't be. The way the word processing programs work, when it has a new item in the list and it doesn't fit in the space available, it drops it down and starts on a new line. And what we have here is actually a very, very long web link. And so it wants to start it on a new line. You'll notice many of the citations start again with the web link on a new line because they are kind of long. However, in this case, it happened to leave a big gap in the middle. That's okay. Don't worry about that one. Now it's your turn to put together your Works Cited page. Remember, library@mccc.edu. We're here to help. Any questions, please feel free to ask. Because that's what we do.